All right, joining me now here on the Matthew Filipovich Show is Molly Neffel. Molly is a comedian, a writer, and the co-host with her brother John of the great radio show Radio Dispatch, which you can find at theradiodispatch.com. You can also find her on Twitter at Molly Neffel. Molly, thank you so much for being on the show.
Thank you very much for having me.
All right, so Molly, you currently have a great article up at Alternet on the New York City bus strike and its impacts towards people when it comes to austerity. For people who don't live in New York or perhaps haven't heard, tell us all about the strike.
Right. So the bus strike, I think, is important for everybody, regardless of where you live in the country, regardless of whether or not you have a child who rides the school bus, because basically, the strike is about it's about saving money. It's about cutting the budget. But in the process, it really is highlighting the value of valuing the bottom line over any sort of cost to the actual humans affected. It really, to me, is a kind of distillation of the supremacy of budget slashing language over over quality of life. And so the strike itself is about basically the city wants to save money by putting out new bus contracts, new school bus contracts. They haven't done this in 33 years since the last school bus strike in 1979. And in 79, after the strike, which from what I understand really crippled the city, they put in place something called employment protection provisions, which basically is a kind of job security so that the city, even if it ended up using a new bus company, that company would still rehire from the same pool of workers, basically meaning that, the people who were there and who were experienced would continue to be rehired over the years rather than always, sweeping out the existing drivers and getting new ones for less money. And so now the city is saying these contracts are too expensive. We need to open them up to the lowest responsible bidder. But the city is saying we can't do the employment protection provisions, basically meaning we got to get rid of the job security. And the union is asking that the city promise to hang on to those protections so that experienced drivers will not lose their jobs.
Well, but seriously, Molly, why would we want bus drivers who are charged with protecting our children, why would we want them to have any type of job security? To me, you want your bus driver to be constantly on edge and worried about losing their job and stressed out and strung out. That's what I want my child's bus driver to be.
Yeah, exactly. And that's really the way that this is being talked about is like, oh, well, who cares, right? We can just, it's expensive. Who cares about the bus drivers? And the fact is that bus drivers are the people who start these kids' days, and also it's worth pointing out that the contracts in question are contracts for about 1,100 routes out of the city's total routes, which is over 7,000, and the routes in question are serving students with disabilities. A bus driver, I think, is important to both disabled and non-disabled students, but especially for disabled students, they might require special attention, special support, and as a counterpoint, people say, well, if we just renegotiate and do this new contracts this one time, we'll save all this money. But I think that the reason it's important is because the way we treat the people who we entrust to care for certain populations of children is a reflection of how we value those children. So if we say these people are utterly replaceable, always in the name of a cheaper bottom line, I think that is really a reflection of whether or not we value those kids.
Absolutely. And I think your point is another thing is, one, this shouldn't be being done to, I'd say, any you know, bus driver for any child. But specifically, like you said, this strike, this route that is being affected by this is for primarily children with who may have disabilities, who may have special needs. And those are children, I mean, all children actually really do, you know, thrive on kind of routine and kind of having, you know, it's something about having some stability in their lives. But even more so, you know, children who have these special needs, like switching out their routine can really be really traumatic to them.
Right. Yeah. Especially, children, you know, children with physical disabilities, obviously might require a special type of bus or special knowledge from a bus matron or bus driver in terms of how they can be safely transported. And then children with, you know, emotional or intellectual disabilities, like kids with autism or kids with developmental disabilities, routine is something that is really important to a lot of children with autism. And so if they're not provided with stability and consistency, it can really make them feel kind of ungrounded and can really affect their whole day. And even though you might say, oh, well, this is just a one-time thing, this contract negotiation basically opens the door to, you know, for always looking for the newest bottom line.
I'm talking to Molly Neffel, host of the Radio Dispatch. But on the other side of this, Molly, let's be fair to Mayor Bloomberg here. On the other side, we're talking about these bus drivers who are millionaires and are making, you know, hundreds of thousands of dollars an hour, and they get, you know, $1 million bonuses every year. So really, these are the people that are destroying the budget, right? I mean, in fact, I'm pretty sure, wasn't it the bus drivers that crashed the economy in 2008?
Yeah, you know, they were always rolling around in their bus Cadillacs and bus Mercedes. Yeah, that's the other thing. I mean, we have moved, the discourse has moved so far to the right in this country about unions, about public sector workers, that the idea that bus drivers would even expect job security now seems out of the question, right? Or it seems like that should, of course, be the first thing to go. It's kind of, the conversation seems to be framed like, well, how dare these guys put our children at risk in order to protect their jobs? And that's, I think we've gotten to a point where that actually seems quite reasonable. And there was one quote in the Times from a driver who was saying, I don't know how they could even hire people and pay them less, because I think he said he made somewhere around $40,000 a year and had been a driver for years and years and years. And so it's, you know,
living the high life on $40,000 a year in New York City, you
right,
know.
New York City. Right. So it's not like these union members are living large. But it sounds like, you know, some of them have a living wage, and you know, the fact that they have the audacity to hope to continue to have this job that they've had for years. Again, we've gotten to a point in this country where that seems like it should be the first thing to go, and that it seems unreasonable for people to expect a living wage and job security.